Welcome to PC Mac. Today we are going to set up Openmediavault 4 on Raspberry Pi 3B Plus. So let's do it. First of all, let's go ahead and open the wireless network watcher to check the IP address of our Raspberry Pi. And here is the IP address, it's 73. So let's go ahead and close this. Let me try to open it on Google Chrome. Sorry, the Mozilla Firefox. So it's open. Let's try to log in with the default username and the password. So when you logged in to your Openmediavault, the first thing that you need to do is go ahead and go to general settings. And first thing that you need to change the web administrator password. You need to enter the password 2 times and then save it. Then go back to web administration right here, and you can see auto logout. So we need to change the settings to disable, so it will not automatically log out after 5 minutes. Let's go ahead and save it. Once we save, it will ask us to save the information, apply the changes, click yes. Once it's done, the first thing that we need to do is go into the bottom, click on SSH, and then enable it and save the settings. Waiting to apply. So the setting is successfully applied. The page will be reloaded now. Now what we need to do is go into the date and time, and from here you need to select the correct date and time. Today's date and time. So the time zone is correct for me, and the date and time is not correct, as you can see here. Let me just do it and correct the date and time. As you can see, it's October 16th. So let's first of all select today's date, and the time is right now 12:31. And then we need to just click on update now. Okay, and again login with the new password that we set it up. It's logged in now. Let's check the date and time. It's on the correct time now, 12:31:57 AM IST. So once this is done, what we need to do is we need to open the Putty and log in to our Openmediavault with root, and the default password is Openmediavault. So I have already changed my password. You need to use the default password, then it will ask you to change the password. So the first thing that we need to do, as we already logged in with the root, so the command apt-get update, we need to run that. And once the update is finished, as you can see, it's moving down. It will take a moment to update the new packages. It's on 0%. It's almost done. Once the update is finished, then we need to go ahead and upgrade all the packages. So we are on the latest package version. It will take a moment to complete it. Then we will run the second command. So it's done. Let's just go ahead and upgrade. So it's also upgraded. So this thing is done. Let's go ahead and go back to the Openmediavault GUI console. Then once it's done, what we need to do is move down to users and create a user of our choice. So let's go ahead and click on add. Let's create a user, PC Mac, then support@pcmac.biz. Let's select a password, confirm the password, and save the account. So now the user is created. Let's go ahead and apply. Now the user is successfully created. Now we will move to the next step, to here, to create the file systems. Before doing that, we need to check which disk on which we will work. So the disk that I have inserted is 16 gigs of flash drive that is inserted here. So the first thing we need to do is click on wipe and then yes, and we just need to go on to quick, so it will be quickly wiping out the disk. So it's done, click on close. So the disk is ready. Once this disk is done, then we need to move to the file system. It will loading up, so it's right here, and this is the SD card, the two partitions. Let's go and create and select the disk that we have just wiped out, and we'll put a label. Let's say let's name it as cloud and click OK. Yes, so it will form it and wipe it. It will be done in a moment because it's a small disk. Now as you can see, the file system creation has completed successfully. So let's go ahead and click on close, and it's done. Now what you need to do is select the drive that we have just created, cloud, and mount it. And once we click on mount, it will asked us to apply the changes. Once the changes are applied, you can see here mounted, yes, 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 and the drive is mounted. Now it can be accessed on the location that is 192.168.1.73. so right now it's not able to access because we need to enable some other settings from here. So to do that, first thing that we need to do is we need to enable the FTP server. To do that, we just need to enable it and then click on save. Then it will ask us to apply the changes again. So we'll apply, yes. Similar here, we need to go to Samba and then enable it. Save. Apply, yes. So now we need to go into shared folder and create some folders here. Let's create. So the first folder we'll create is www. If you're going to create any kind of web server, for that the folder is www. Click yes, so it's created. Apply, yes. Now the next folder will be movies. Select the same drive, yes. Save. Apply, yes. Now the next is songs. So these all folders are created and we need to share them over the FTP and to the Samba server as well. So we'll go to the FTP again and then shares, add the folders, movies, save. We need to do the same thing with all the folders so they can share over the FTP. Now we need to do the same thing with Samba server as well. Let me do that. So now all these folders are shared onto the network through the Samba server. So let's go ahead and check whether we are able to access our folders or not. As you can see, so the username that we have created is PC Mac and the password, let's remember, and then OK. And as you can see, movies, songs, and www are right here. Let me just close it, click on our username, and let's give some privilege to this user, read and write privileges to all three folders, and save it. We need to click on apply, yes. Now we need to go into the shared folder from here and click on the first one. We can select privileges from here, and as already selected the privileges for PC Mac to these folders, so it's a read and write privilege. So it will be done for all three folders from the user tab, as you can see here. And from here, the ACL, we can provide a read and write to the PC Mac user. Let's click on apply. So the settings are done now. Now the NAS is created through the Open Media Vault 4 You can go ahead and do it by yourself as well. If you want to know how to download it, and if you're facing any problem related to the graphical user interface that you are not able to log into the graphical user interface, I'll leave the link in the end of the video. You can go through that video and you can easily resolve that problem with your OpenMediaVault. So guys, that's it from my end, how you can set up your OpenMediaVault 4 on Raspberry Pi. If you have any comments, please go ahead and write them in the comment section. I'll try to answer them. Apart from that, if you like my video, please go ahead and hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.